मन तेरा नचारी तेरा नचारी यमुन तेरा नचारी तेरा नचारी जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारी जनल्लभा गिरिवरधारी गोपी जनल्लभा गिरिवरधारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय राधा माधव राधा माधव राधे राधा माधव राधे जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा जय गुरुदेवा जय गुरुदेवा गुरुदेवा जय गुरुदेवा देवा जय गुरुदेवा गुरुदेवा जय गुरुदेवा नित्य गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्य गौर हरि बोल श्री 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 राधा माधव की जय जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय पति पान गुरु महाराज की समवेत भक्त बृंद की जय आल ग्लोरी श्रासमुल डेवटी हरे कृष्ण आल ग्लोरी श्रासमुल डेवटी हरे कृष्ण आल ग्लोरी श्रासमुल डेवटी हरे कृष्ण आल ग्लोरी आल ग्लोरी श्री गुरु अन गौरंग आल ग्लोरी श्री जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद जय श्रील प्रभुपाद हरे कृष्ण सो वंस अगेन वी वेलकम यू आल टू दिस मॉर्निंग Srimad Bhagavatam class and our Sunday love feasting program. So today, so Srimad Bhagavatam sloka is first canto, 13th chapter, 48th verse. So it is already written in the board. So you can also watch at it. You can read, you can go through it once. So I'll just read it out and please repeat after me. So before that, so we'll chant Mangalacharan prayers. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं उदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती रुत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नैष्टिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। नमो पंकजनाभाय नमो पंकजमालिने नमो पंकजनेत्राय नमस्ते पंकजांग्रिये। मुखं करोति वाचालं पंगुलंगायते गिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारिणं परमानंदा माधवं श्रीचैतन्याईश्वरं। हरिओं तत्सत्। So today's Hare Krishna. So very happy to see new faces. So thanks Prabhu for coming to our Srimad Bhagavatam class. So we are seeing you for the first time. So we welcome you to our Medalli Bhakti Center, Prabhu. Both of you. Very happy to see both of you here. Your good names, Prabhu?
Aditya.
Aditya, Prabhu?
Keshav.
Sir, you are already into Krishna consciousness, Prabhu. You are already in touch with Krishna consciousness. Okay. Hare Krishna. So Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, 13th chapter, 48th verse. So the chapter name is Dhritarashtra quits home. So Dhritarashtra, so who was once the emperor of the total world, so now he is quitting this home. Who formerly attached to this rashtra, now he is quitting this rashtra. So this particular chapter will throw so many enlightenments so that we can come back to our senses and we can perfect ourselves and go back to Godhead. So one of the wonderful verses, so first canto 13th chapter 48th verse, tadidam bhagavan rajan तदिदं भगवान् राजन् एकात्मा आत्मनं स्वदृक् एकात्मा आत्मनं स्वदृक् अंतरो अनंतरो भाति अंतरो अनंतरो भाति पश्यतां माययोरुडा पश्यतां माययोरुडा तदिदं भगवान् राजन् तदिदं भगवान् राजन् एकात्मा आत्मनं स्वदृक् एकात्मा आत्मनं स्वदृक् अंतरो अनंतरो भाति अंतरो अनंतरो भाति पश्यतां माययोरुडा पश्यतां माययोरुडा। प्रभुजी तदिदं भगवान् राजन् एकात्मनात्मनं स्वदृक् अंतरो अनंतरो भाति पश्यतां माययोरुडा तदिदं भगवान् राजन् एकात्मात्मनं स्वदृक् अंतरो अनंतरो भाति पश्यतां माययोरुडा। माताजी तदिदं भगवान् राजन् एकात्मा आत्मनां स्वदृक् अंतरो अनंतरो भाति
Pasetamayorda. Word to word translation. So please repeat after me. Tat. Therefore. Idam. This manifestation. Bhagavan. The personality of Godhead. Rajan. O King. Ekaha. One without a second. Atma. The super soul. Atmanam. By his energies. Swadrik. Qualitatively. Like him. Antaraha. Without. Anantaraha. Within. And by himself. Bhati. So manifest. Pasya. Look. Tam. Unto him only. Mayaya. By manifestations of different energies. Uruda. Appears to be many. So translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Therefore, O King, you should look to the Supreme Lord only, who is one without a second, and who manifests himself by different energies and is both within and without. Purport. The Supreme Lord personality of Godhead is one without a second, but he manifests himself by different energies because he is by nature blissful. The living beings are also manifestations of his marginal energy, qualitatively one with the Lord, and there are innumerable living beings both within and without the external and internal energies of the Lord. Since the spiritual world is a manifestation of the Lord's internal energy, the living beings within that internal potency are qualitatively one with the Lord without contamination from the external potency. Although qualitatively one with the Lord, the living being, due to contamination of the material world, is pervertedly manifested, and therefore he experiences so-called happiness and distress in the material world. Such experiences are all ephemeral and do not affect the spirit soul. The perception of such ephemeral happiness and distress is due only to the forgetfulness of his qualities, which are equal to the Lord's. There is, however, a regular current from the Lord himself from within and without, by which to rectify the fallen condition of the living being. From within he corrects the desiring living beings as localized Paramatma, and from without he corrects by his manifestations, the spiritual master and the revealed scriptures. One should look unto the Lord. One should not be disturbed by the so-called manifestations of happiness or distress, but he should try to cooperate with the Lord in his outward activities for correcting the fallen souls. By his order only, one should become a spiritual master and cooperate with the Lord. One should not become a spiritual master for one's personal benefit, for some material gain, or as an avenue of business or occupation of earning livelihood. Bona fide spiritual masters who look unto the Supreme Lord to cooperate with him are actually qualitatively one with the Lord, and the forgetful ones are perverted reflections only. Yudhishthira Maharaj is advised by Narada, therefore, not to be disturbed by the affairs of so-called happiness and distress, but look only unto the Lord to execute the mission for which the Lord has descended. That was his prime duty. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshurum Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Jai Guru Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. So, since 2 months, so we are discussing on this particular chapter, Dhritarashtra quits home. So, in this particular scene, actually, Dhritarashtra, was advised by Vidura, to quit home, so that at least now itself, if you practice devotional service, so we can go to back to Godhead, or there is a chance to go to back to Godhead. So please quit home. Don't attach to this kingdom like that. Vidura advises Dhritarashtra, and on his advice, after so many times he advised, so at last, so he was enlightened, and he quits his home without informing Yudhishthira Maharaj. So, and by the time Yudhishthira Maharaj come back, to take blessings from Dhritarashtra. So Dhritarashtra was not seen there, and Yudhishthira was perturbed. So, and he was bewildered. what happened to my elder uncle, so what happens to him without any announcement or without any information, he left this kingdom. So he was asking Dhritarashtra's secretary Sanjaya, so but Sanjaya also he was also helpless. He also doesn't know the information where Dhritarashtra went. So then so at that particular time Narada Muni comes to the scene. So why Narada Muni came there? Why Narada Muni came there? Yes, very good. So actually Narada Muni is a spiritual master of all the living entities actually. So he is the transcendental representative of the Supreme Lord. So whenever there is necessity by the arrangement of the Lord, so Narada Muni so will appear into the particular situations. Hare Krishna, whoever wants Kannada or Telugu translation, so they can go back. So Swarupalak Prabhu is translating the Bhagavatam class from English to Kannada. Hare Krishna. So yararki English gottagillavo, so avaru Swarupalak Prabhu hatra hogidre, so Prabhu translate martta iddaru, so you can hear about him. Hare Krishna. So whenever there is necessity by the arrangement of Lord, so this transcendental devotee, so he will help the fallen conditioned souls, so by giving his transcendental teachings. So such is one of the situation where Yudhishthira Maharaj was bewildered. So he was thinking that I am the protector of these elderly people, but without my notice these people they went out of this kingdom and they are now in forest. So what happens to them? So say generally a father so will be worried after his child. Why? Because when a child goes out of home or when a child was misplaced somewhere, so then father will naturally he will become bewildered about his son. So where my child has gone, what he has eaten, so whether something has happened to him, like that a father will be in disturbed mind. In the same way Yudhishthir, being a responsible king and a responsible family member, elderly family member, so he was taking care of Yudhishthir. So he was taking care of Dhritarashtra and Gandhari, so who were elder to all the Pandavas and who were taken care by them, so when they were in childhood. So now because of his bewilderment, as he is thinking that I am the maintainer of or I am the protector of these two elderly people, so as now they are not visible in front of him, so he was bewildered. So that is why he was lamenting, because of me or I did something wrong or because of my karma or something, so he was so much bewildered. So at that particular time, so Narada Muni appears there. So we can say like from 13th chapter, this first canto 13th chapter 41 verse to first canto 13th chapter 60th verse, so Narada Muni instructions are there. After hearing Narada Muni instruction, he was consoled. So this is called like little Narada Gita, minute Narada Gita. So we have another Gitas also. What is the famous Gita which we are always in touch with? Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita spoken by whom to whom? So Lord Krishna spoken to Arjuna. So and in the same chapter, so in the first canto, in the same this chapter only, from 18th verse to 28th verse, Vidura so advises Dhritarashtra. This we can mention as Vidura Gita, because whenever there is a instruction, instructor and instructee, so that is called a Gita, right? So here Vidura instructing Dhritarashtra, that is why you can call it as a Vidura Gita. And in the same way, so this Vidura Gita is 1.13.18 to 1.13.28 in the same chapter. In the after that, when Narada Muni appears, he also instruct Yudhishthira Maharaj, so that is also called as minute Narada Gita. We have Narada Pancharatra, right? We have Narada Pancharatra, Narada Bhakti Sutra, like that we can mention it as Narada Gita. So when Narada Muni instruct Yudhishthira Maharaj got enlightened. So that particular verses are from 1.13.41 to 13.59. So Naradamuni. So 19 shlokas he recited. After getting this knowledge, Yudhishthira Maharaj understand that I am not the ultimate protector or I am not the maintainer. So knowing that, he will become peace at his mind. And there are also different Gitas in Srimad Bhagavatam. There are different Gitas are there. See, do you know about Uddhava Gita? Uddhava Gita. So in the 11th canto, almost 3/4 of the 11th canto was the instruction of Lord Krishna to Uddhava. As most of the shlokas were given to Uddhava, it is also famously mentioned as Uddhava Gita, and it is also called as Hamsa Gita. It is also called as Hamsa Gita. Why? Because so during while narrating to Uddhava, so Lord, so he will narrate an instance where Hamsa avatara of Lord narrating to the sons of Brahma. So because that was narrated to the Uddhava, it is also called as Hamsa Gita. And there are also Anu Gita. So have you heard about Anu Gita? Anu Gita, so this is also the same. So Krishna spoken to Arjuna. So this will come in Mahabharata, in Ashwamedha Parva. In Ashwamedha Parva, actually what happens after the war, Yudhishthira Maharaj performs Ashwamedha Yaga. So to establish himself as the emperor of the world, he has to perform one Ashwamedha Yagna. During that time, so Arjuna was bewildered. So and at that time he lost his peace and he was unable to remember the Bhagavad Gita shlokas at that time. So then he requested Krishna, can you please re-spoke up again this Bhagavad Gita. Then, so in short, Krishna narrates Bhagavad Gita once again to Arjuna. So that Gita is called Anu Gita. Understood? That Gita is called Anu Gita. So Krishna again spoke Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna. So that is called Anu Gita. And we have like Rudra Gita. So Rudra, who is Rudra? Shiva. Lord Shiva himself narrating the sons of Prachetas. So it is there in 4th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, 71st chapter. So it is also wonderful. So Lord Shiva explain the glories of the Supreme Lord and explain the glories of devotional service to the Prachetas. So this was very, very famous, especially our Vaishnavas. So during the time of Sivaratri, they will recite these shlokas. So this is called Rudra Gita. Sri Sisi Gaurani Thai Ki, Sri Sisi Gandharka Giridhari, Sri Manchetana Mahaprabhu, Sri Sisi Lakshmi Narasimhadeva Anandaya Bhaktaradra Lad Maharaj Ki Jai, Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. And we have also Aila Gita. In the same Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, there is a particular chapter which is called Aila Gita. Aila is another name of Pururava. Pururava is one of the emperor of the world who was enamored by the Apsara Urvasi. So this in detail was explained in the chapter. In the 9th canto it was detailedly explained about the life history of Pururava. And we also have Bhishma Gita. So where this incident will come? Bhishma Gita. Yes. So during Shanti Parva, so Yudhishthira Maharaj was bewildered because he was thinking that I am the cause of killing of these 64 crores of people. So even though Krishna, how many times he consoled, but Yudhishthira was not consoled. At that time Krishna planned that, so if I somehow take Yudhishthira and Pandavas to Bhishma Pitamaha, with the words of Bhishma, I think at least Yudhishthira Maharaj get consoled like that, he thought. And so he advised all the Pandavas to go to Bhishma Deva in Kurukshetra. At that time Bhishma Deva narrates wonderful information, and he advises Yudhishthira Maharaj how to rule the total world as a king. So what and all should be there, what not to be done, what should be done, like that everything he narrates. So that too by sleeping on bed of arrows. So that was famously called as Bhishma Gita. Okay, na? So, and there is one more Gita. So it is very famous. So which will be seen in 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. from it is especially 31st chapter. Can anybody guess what is that Gita? 10th canto, 31st chapter. So the glorification of Supreme Lord by his intimate associates. Who are those intimate associates? Gopis. So it is called Gopi Gita. Right? So this, like this, there are so many Gitas. Why am I narrating this thing means? So this Gita sometimes instructor and instructee relationship will be there in some types of Gita. In some types of Gitas, it is like soliloquy. That means he only sings that particular slokas. So that means Lord or Vyasadeva. So he narrated or he written those slokas which are enlightening to the soul. That is why. So Vyasadeva has included Aila Gita. Aila Gita is a song composed by Pururava after understanding that Apsarasa Urvasi is the manifestation of Maya. Because of her, he understood that he was cheated by her. And after that, he understood that this Maya is the cause of bondage. And after quitting her, he understood that ultimately Supreme Personality of Godhead is the main protector of me. And after understanding this, he will quit the material world and he enters into spiritual world by practicing Bhakti Yoga. See, in this particular verse, so after Narada Muni given instruction, Yudhishthir Maharaj was slowly he is coming to his senses. So in this particular verse, so when we see the translation, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Shri Krishna, sorry, therefore, O King, you should look to the Supreme Lord only, who is one without a second, and who manifests himself by different energies, and is both within and without. So, as Yudhishthir Maharaj got bewildered that he was taking care of the Dhritarashtra, so now Dhritarashtra was no more in his palace. So Yudhishthir got bewildered. So that is why Narada Muni is enlightening, is consoling that, Oh my dear Yudhishthir, don't be panic or don't be unhappy that so your elderly Dhritarashtra and Gandhari they went out of the palace without informing you, but you don't think that you are the ultimate protector. So ultimate protector or ultimate well-wisher of the every living entity is Supreme Lord himself. So by illusion you may think that you are the maintainer of the this kingdom, but actually who is the maintainer of all the living entities? Supreme Lord Krishna himself. So how he protects all the living entities, whether he is coming directly and protecting us? Does really Krishna coming and protecting us? So how he protects us? Yes, Prabhu, thank you. So as Prabhu was mentioning, Lord was seated as Paramatma in everyone's heart. So by sitting in the heart of every living entity, so he was internally protecting us, internally guiding us as Chaitya Guru. So the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, he will manifest externally as spiritual master. So that is why our Vedas will say, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheswaraha, Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri Guru Namaha. So that is why we have to treat our spiritual master as God himself. But spiritual master, he should not think that he is God. But we have to think or we have to treat our spiritual master as God himself. Why? Because Lord himself narrating to Uddhava, that I will externally manifest as spiritual master or scriptures. So Lord has manifested in this world as a beautiful scripture. What are those scriptures? Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita. So Supreme Lord, he himself manifested as a book. Books, those are called Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. And he also externally manifested as spiritual master. So, So when human beings, especially living entities, got bewildered, then at that particular time, so Lord, as an internal energy or internal Paramatma, He will guide from within. But when you are not able to understand the instruction of the Paramatma inside, so then Lord manifests outside as spiritual master. So because of spiritual master instruction, by taking his instruction, by taking his advice, under his guidance, if you serve, so then, so you will be coming out of your illusions. So slowly, slowly, so by constantly following his instruction, you will get out of the this Maya. So actually Supreme Lord, how internally or externally, or he will control the whole world, means because of his energies. So even though we cannot able to see the see the energies of the Lord, but we can grasp with our intellectual platform that there are different energies of the Lord are working on this particular world. So it is said in Srimad Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter 4th verse. So can anybody guess? So in the 7th chapter 4th verse, to which energy of the Lord is mentioning? In the 7th chapter 4th verse. 4th verse. So he is explaining one of the energy of the Lord. So that energy is inferior energy, that is called Bhumirapo analovayu kammano buddhirevacha ahankaram itiyamme binna prakrutirastada. So Lord has actually three energies. So one energy is called superior energy, another energy called inferior energy, and the third energy is called marginal energy. So it is very important to know the energies of the Lord. When you understand the energies of the Lord, then you can understand how Lord manifest or how Lord control this world, right? So how many energies are there? Lord has got how many energies? Three energies. What are those energies? Internal energy, external energy, and marginal energy, right? So in the 7th chapter 4th verse, Lord is explaining about his inferior energy. What is that inferior energy is comprising of? Bhumi rapo analo vayu kamano buddhi revacha ahankaram itiyamme binna prakruti astada. Binna prakruti. So this binna prakruti is otherwise called as bhautika prakruti, or otherwise is called bahiranga shakti, or otherwise it is called material energy, right? Who is responsible for this material energy? Who is the personified of material energy? Now we are all celebrating this Navaratri celebration. Who will worship in this 9 days? Durga. So Durga means she is the fort. That means she is the supervisor of this fort. So unless until her, without her permission, nobody can get out from this fort. This material world is called like a fort, which is controlled by, or which is looking after by Mother Durga or Mother Parvati. So it is inferior energy of the Lord. So this inferior energy comprises of Panchabhutas. So what are Panchabhutas? Fire. Yes, water. So these are called Panchabhutas. And about this, three more subtle elements are there: mind, intelligence, and ego. So all these 8 ingredients are called inferior energy of the Lord, and personified of this material energy is called Durga Devi. And Lord has, if there is inferior energy, then there must be another energy which is superior to that energy. So what is that energy is called? Superior energy, that is called spiritual energy or internal potency of the Lord. So this internal potency is manifested as spiritual worlds. So what are those spiritual worlds are called? What are those spiritual worlds are called? Whether spiritual worlds are existing or not? Existing or not? So, Lords the what it is called? Vaikuntha or Goloka, right? So his internal potency is manifested as Vaikuntha Lokas, and his material energy is manifested as material world, which we are living now, right? So I have explained about external energy of the Lord and internal energy of the Lord. In the external energy of the Lord, who will live? In the external energy of the Lord, who will live? Or in the external world of the Lord, who will live? Or in this material world of the Lord, who will live? All conditioned souls like us, right? So if somebody are there in this conditioned world, then why not in the spiritual world? Whether they are living entities in the spiritual world or not? Whether there are living entities in the spiritual world or not? Are there or not? There are. Have you seen? We cannot see them by our blunt eyes. But there are Ananta Koti Vaishnavas in spiritual world. There are Ananta Koti Vaishnavas. So we are actually limited Koti Vaishnavas or limited Koti conditioned souls here. But there are Ananta Koti Vaishnavas in the spiritual world. So we cannot count them. So that many living entities are there, because 3/4 of the Lord's manifestation is spiritual world, and only 1/4 of the Lord's manifestation is material world. So that means we are thinking that in this total world there are 700 crores of living entities. But if you compare to this material world, so 3/4 of the spiritual world is there. So that means if you say, suppose whatever visible in this earthly planet itself, so only earthly planet, that too one dvipa. So we are in one dvipa. Actually this is called Bharatakanda. In this Bharatakanda itself there are 700 crores of living entities, that too only human beings. What about other living entities? We are not counting them. So there are again Sapta Dvipas in this Bhumandala itself. And what about Swargaloka, Bhuvarloka, Chandraloka, Suryaloka? There are so many lokas are there. So and in the down also there are Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Rasatala, Mahatala, Patala. There are also so many living entities are there. So that means in this material world itself there are some crores of living entities. Then Lord is mentioning that there are Ananta Koti Vaishnavas in the spiritual world. So what is the difference between those people who are living in the spiritual world and those people living in this material world? Is there any difference, or both are the same? Why both are not the same? Why we are put into in this material world, and why they are in spiritual world? Yes, we are criminals. We are conditioned. That is why we are put into this jail in this material world. Why we have become criminals? We have cunning nature from our state. So any other reasons why we are put into this jail? We wanted to enjoy like the Lord, or we want to imitate the Lord, right? So actually Lord has given some freedom for every living entities. So this freedom, this is called free will. So when this free will is utilized to serve the Lord, so without surpassing the laws of the Lord, then such living entities are never contaminated and they will be eternally live in spiritual world. And if one utilizes this free will, and if he misuses this free will, then he will get punishment. See, we have our government laws in this world. So when you are going in the traffic signal, if you cross the red signal, what happens? You will be caught and you will put into jail. Why? Because you have denied the laws of the government. That is why you are a criminal. That is why you are put into jail. In the same way, Lord has also given some freedom for us. But with that freedom, we have to serve the Lord. Instead of serving the Lord, if you misuse this freedom, then what will happen? the superintendent of jail Durga Devi put us into this material world. Then under her rule we have to work here. So and in this world there will be dualities. So when we are put into this world, we will be under the contamination of three modes of material nature. What are the three modes of material nature? Right? Sattva, Raja and Tamoguna. Actually what happens now, because we have misused our free will, so we were put it into this Bhava Sagara. So what is Sagara? What is the meaning of Sagara? Ocean. So when a person put it into Sagara or ocean, whether he is happy? Why he is not happy? He is not a fish, na? If fish is put into ocean, it will happily swim and it will enjoy the ocean. But how much time we can enjoy in the ocean? Very little time, na? After that, what will happen? We lose our energy and we cannot swim in the that ocean. So, and moreover, in the ocean, everything is, will be very happy. Our conditions are very friendly to us. No. So there are continuous tides. So in the ocean, continuously there will be tides. So one is incoming tide and another one is upcoming tide. And moreover, in the ocean, very friendly creatures are there. In the ocean, very friendly creatures will be there. There will be big, big whales. In one gulp, it will eat our total body, right? And there will be shark fishes. There will be crocodiles, right? So in such material world, in such type of ocean, whether we can live happily, it is very difficult to live happily. Why? Because there are dangerous creatures in the ocean, right? So at that time, who will protect you? You are putting into the ocean, so then around of you there are dangerous creatures, so, and you lost your energy, you are not able to swim also, then who will protect you? So this is the situation. So that ocean is called Bhava Sagara. That ocean is Bhava Sagara, and the living entity who was put into this Bhava Sagara was all of us. We are all put into this Bhava Sagara. So when we are suffering like this, Supreme Lord, who is a loving father, so he descends to this world to protect us. So to take us back to this, from material world to spiritual world. So then Supreme Lord descends into this material world to take us back to Goloka. So why he has to come here? Why Supreme Lord has to come here? Why he has to come here? To protect us. Why he has to protect us? Why he has to protect us? What is the relation between him and me, him and us? We are part and parcel of the Lord. We are the sons of the Lord. Right? We are the children of the Lord. So whether a father will be happy if his son is suffering? So no father will be happy if his son is suffering. So that is why to reclaim this conditioned soul who are suffering by the three modes of material nature. So, and four dukkhas. So what are the four dukkhas? Every living entity suffers in this material world. So Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadhi. Every living entity is suffering in this material world with these four dukkhas. Janma, Mrityu, Jara and Vyadhi. So that is the reason now and then Supreme Lord descend to this world, so to take back this suffering conditioned soul. Even though Supreme Lord comes here, sometimes we will ignore, because we were trapped in the material condition of life because of the illusionary objects put by the Maya Devi. So that is why whenever devotees request, Prabhuji, please take Bhagavad Gita, so that will, this will help you, this will change your life. Then when we go for book distribution, this type of answers will come. I am not interested. I don't have any time. Right? I am very busy. So these are the things put by Maya, so to cover you, so to not go to this devotional service. Because of this Maya situation, whenever Prabhu calls, Prabhuji, can you come for Bhakti Ruksha? Prabhuji, I am going to outside. Prabhu, I am very, very busy. Or So whenever we call for Sunday Bhagavatam class, are you coming, Prabhu? No, Prabhu, I have some other duty. These are like, no, sometimes it is compulsory, but sometimes no, because of Maya's arrangement, so we will miss these programs. So, but after that we'll lament, unnecessarily I have missed the class. So these are like Maya's arrangements. That is why Supreme Lord, as internally, he will push us. So today you missed Bhagavatam class, or today you missed Bhagavad Gita class, or you missed Bhakti Ruksha. So you go to Bhakti Ruksha. In somehow or other, you will be protected from this Maya Devi, or else Maya will protect, Maya will entraps you. In that way, Lord continuously passes some current in our body as internal energy, as Chaitya Guru, Lord, as a Paramatma, he will give current inside. If we are not understanding Lord's current inside, then he will send spiritual master. So then when spiritual master comes, by his instruction, sometimes, so spiritual master, they should become very strict. So they will sometimes, you know, they will scold also. So but when a spiritual master scold us, is it really harm to us? Or when a superior devotee scolds an inferior devotee, is it really harm to that particular inferior devotee? It is not a harm, but it is actually blessings, right? When a spiritual master scolds us, we should feel that. So Lord is protecting us through spiritual master. So, and Lord also manifests as scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. You see, almost many of the foreigners, by reading Srila Prabhupada's books, even though they are full of Maya, full of illusions, how they got protected? Just by reading Srila Prabhupada's books. After reading Srila Prabhupada's books, so many people who wanted to do suicide also, after just reading Srila Prabhupada's books, so they come out of that situation and they have become the temple presidents. How it is possible? Because Supreme Lord has manifested as Srila Prabhupada's books. So just by reading Srila Prabhupada's books, so many of the foreigners have become nice devotees and they become presidents of the so many temples. So that is why you should not think that you are the maintainer or everything is dependent on you. But you have to think that Supreme Lord, on a purpose and a mission, he comes to this material world and he has some mission. If you cooperate with the mission of the Lord, and if you are not contaminated by the material aspects of this world, then you will be considered as a spiritual master. A spiritual master is none other than the mercy representation of the Supreme Lord. So they are in qualitatively same like Supreme Lord. So they are called Nitya Siddhas. So are there Nitya Siddhas in this world? Are there Nitya Siddhas in this world? They will come sometime, so to enlighten us. But most of this world is filled with Nitya Baddhas like us. We are all Nitya Baddhas. But to enlighten us and to reclaim us to back to Godhead, these Nitya Siddhas will come. So those are like Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Maharaj, Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, all these four bona fide sampradayas, guru paramparas, they are all called Nitya Siddhas. Actually, there are eternal Nitya Siddhas in the spiritual worlds. Whenever there is necessity, whenever there is a need, then those Nitya Siddhas, on the order of Supreme Lord Krishna, they will descend to this world. That is why their birth is called Jayanti, or their birth is called Appearance Day. So, and when they pass from this world, it is called as Disappearance Day, or it is called Vardanti. That means whether they take birth in this world or whether they get out of from this world, it is called as it is called as a festival, right? That is why, so these Nitya Siddhas, so who are qualitatively equal to the Supreme Lord, so they will also come to this material world, so to preach glories of the Lord and to understand, to make us understand what is the purpose of the human form of life. When we came to hear such lectures, or when came to hear such preachings, or one time or another time, so we'll come to our senses, then we'll come into devotional service. So almost here all of us, we came into this devotional service by the preachings of one or other devotee, right? So these are all called our saviors. So these are all called external manifestations of the Supreme Lord. That is why we have to cooperate with the Lord. So when we cooperate with the Lord, at one particular time, Lord empower us. Then such person will become spiritual master. So when a person is empowered by the Supreme Lord, he can be considered as spiritual master. But there are some people, so just by reading Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam, if they got some preaching techniques, if they are very proficient with Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, they will utilize such knowledge or such quality or such such great quality for the earning of the money. So they will earn the money through preaching Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam. They will be like called professional reciters. So, but in the Vedas, it is strictly prohibited that you should not earn by preaching Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam. So that is actually strictly prohibited. If you know Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam, you should freely preach it. But Srila Prabhupada will tell us, you can charge something when you are particularly called by somebody to their house program or to any function in their home. At that time we can charge, but that amount also we should not utilize for our personal self. To what purpose we can utilize that money? For temple purpose, for temple programs, for ISKCON preaching programs, we can charge that amount. So okay na? So that is why, so we should always think that Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, he descends to this material world, or he sends his representatives into this world so as to reclaim all fallen conditioned souls like this. So can anybody name some of the representatives of the Lord into this material world who with their preachings has converted many of the people into devotees? So in the Islam, one person has changed the total Muslim countries. So who is that person? Muhammad Pravakta. And what about Christian countries? Jesus Christ. So in the same way, our Indian countries, there are Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Shankaracharya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Lord himself, but he came as a devotee. And after that, so there is a big guru parampara, a big chain is there. So where nearly 26 of the gurus are listed. So all these personalities are the representatives of the Lord. And on the same way, in that guru parampara itself, one more greatest personality is there, who is narrating this Narada Gita to Yudhishthira Maharaj. Who is that person? Narada. Narada is preaching to Yudhishthira Maharaj that don't be bewildered. Don't think that you are the ultimate protector. So already Lord is arranged everything. So your uncle Dhritarashtra and Gandhari, from now, after 5 days, he will be enter into the fire, and he will become into ashes. Don't think of him, because he will take another body based on his karma. So now what your prime duty is, now Supreme Personality of Godhead is departing from this material world because his mission was accomplished. He came, so he killed all the demons in this material world. So whom and all Krishna has killed in this material world? All the demons of Vraja. So all the demons of Vraja he has killed. So he has killed Jarasandha by his arrangement, and he has also killed Kamsa, and so many other demons also he has killed. And in the Kurukshetra war also he finished almost all the demons of the world. So now he also established Yudhishthira Maharaj as a king. So then what is the duty? And he also somehow killed all his Yadu Vamsha also. So now who will be there? Who are there in this material world to any function is there to the Supreme Lord Krishna? So he has done all his duties. Now it is the time to the Lord to go back to Vaikuntha. So now, O Yudhishthira, so Supreme Lord is going back to his spiritual world. So now it is your duty, without lamenting for your uncle, get prepared for going to Vaikuntha. So if you keep on lamenting like this, you will stay forever in this material world. That is why I am instructing you. You now it is your duty to always think of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Just by thinking of Supreme Lord every 24 hours, so then we can easily go to back to Godhead. This is the instruction given by Narada to bewildered Yudhishthira. So actually this is not only for Yudhishthira. Actually Yudhishthira is a liberated soul. So but Narada Muni, he is making Yudhishthira as instrument. He is preaching all of us. So we are thinking that this person has gone, that person has gone, my well-wishers has gone, my lovely persons are gone. So what I have to do like that? So many living entities or conditioned souls are lamenting in this world. So to enlighten us, Narada Muni making Yudhishthira as instrument, he is narrating us. Everything is under the control of the Supreme Lord. You never think that you are the controller, but you think as a servant or custodian of the particular living entity. As soon as your duty is over, so it is your responsibility to think of the Supreme Lord. As soon as you think of the Supreme Lord, then there are chances that you can quit this material world and go back to Vaikuntha. Hare Krishna. So thank you very much for patiently listening to me. So Grandhara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna. Now Vedadari Prabhu, so he will give a class on Nityananda. Hare Krishna.